you go.
What is up, guys? I do hope you're well. My name is Mark, and we're back with some more Entitled People. If you're new here, please consider hitting that like, that subscribe, and maybe that notification bell, as it truly, truly helps out this channel. And with that being said, let's get straight into today's stories. Much love, guys. Our first story comes from The Scarlet Jones. Entitled parent literally coughs in a cop's face. EP entitled parent, C cop. I truly wish I could say this was a fake story. So as of today, 3rd, 2620, Colorado has been put on lockdown because of COVID-19. The only exceptions are essential employees, going out for groceries, and walking your dog, as was stated in a statewide text we got. So I'm walking my dog, and I've seen a few families out and about, because it's fucking Colorado, and the people here don't understand what a lockdown is. I'm not kidding, this state is full of idiots. So I'm walking my dog past the park slash tennis court by my neighborhood, and I see a family, mother, two sons, and an infant. Yes, a literal infant. And I notice they're yanking on the gates to a tennis court. Now, a little fun fact about the parking lot to the park is there's often a speed trap area, and even now we have cops in it. So I see an officer leave his car and approach the family. I was a little bit away, so some details might be fuzzy, but this is what I heard. The cop said, "Excuse me, ma'am." She was the one pulling on the gate. "Are you aware on the statewide lockdown right now?" She says, "Yes, officer, but it says we're allowed to go out for the essentials." The cop says, "Yes, ma'am. Is there an essential reason you need to get into the tennis court?" He didn't ask this sarcastically. He was being genuine. She said, "Yes, sir. My son here is sick of being stuck in the house and wanted to play tennis. Can you please find me the key for this gate?" The cop pauses for a second and then starts, "Ma'am, I'm sorry, but this is not an essential utility. You and your family need to go home." She says, "Excuse me, we have a right to be out here. We aren't going to stay home on a lovely day like this. All of this coronavirus is just a marketing scam anyways." The officer was genuinely baffled at this point. He said, "Mom, I'm sorry, but you and your family need to go home now." She said, "We're not going home. Now open this gate for us so my sons can play tennis." "Mom, please, this isn't my personal decision. It's for the safety of the elderly and the children." She said, "If the market is so worried about my children, then we wouldn't be making up this fake pandemic so they can later sell us poison and demand we inject our babies with it." The cop says, "I'm not here to challenge your beliefs, but again, it's not up to me, it's up to the state." She says, "Well, if everyone needs to be at home, why don't you go home?" He says, "Trust me, I would like to, but this is my job." She says, "Well, we're not going home. I want to make sure my kids have a good memory of their childhood and not being locked in the house." The cop said, "It's only for 2 weeks, ma'am." "Well, I don't care. Now, if you're not going to help us, leave us alone. We're trying to enjoy a family outing." I'm not certain he did, but it looked like the cop reached for his handcuffs or radio or something like that. "Ma'am, you need to leave now." I'm going to guess he actually did reach for something because EP looked down, then literally pulls back and coughs in his face. EP said, "Well, officer, now you're sick, so you should be the one going home." I swear, I've never seen so much fury across a man's face in my entire life. If the kids weren't there, I'm pretty sure he'd have tased her. After he came out of shock, he called for backup on his radio. Probably for the kids or something. I wouldn't be surprised if she's in the news tomorrow. Oh man, it's like, why would someone do that? And with a pandemic going on, all the stuff on the news about it, keeping away from each other, and this person coughs in a cop's face. How stupid you have to be. In fact, I know someone who's a cashier at a local store, and because they couldn't buy 3 pints of milk, the person coughed in their face too. So this isn't a new thing. But the person just walked out the store, and I said to my friend, I said, "Why don't you report that? Because surely that's got to be like near illegal at this point. That's dangerous." Our next story is from Fabulous Little Queen. Homophobic entitled aunt finds out I'm not straight. "Hello, cherubs. I'm back. So we're in lockdown at the minute, and I figured, why not post another installment about my entitled aunt? It can help me pass some time and act as kind of therapy. Not been a fun week. Anyways, I'll probably post about how my entitled aunt reacted when she found out that I was a drag queen at some point this week. Not much else to do when you can't leave the house. But this story will focus on her meltdown upon finding out I was gay. EA was right. Shocker. Seriously though, I don't believe that my favourite colour or toy as a child turned me gay. I was a fabulous biatch from the moment I was born." Anyways, I'd have been 15 at the time of this story. Now it's around this age that kids, in the area I grew up anyways, will start to get their first boyfriends and girlfriends. Nothing serious or anything, puppy love I guess. It was around this time that I started to realise that I wasn't attracted to girls. I thought they were pretty, funny, smart, etc, but I never wanted a girlfriend. It didn't take me long to figure out that I was gay. My mum had several gay friends, and even she herself is bisexual, so coming out was something that I never really feared. I told my mum that I was gay when we were watching a movie, and she just gave me a hug and told me that she loved me no matter what. Anyways, a couple of weeks later, we headed to my grandma and grandpa's house for a family barbecue, and of course, Entitled Aunt was there. Now, important note, I'd brought my boyfriend with me. We had been best friends since we were like 5, and had started dating about a week or so before I told my mum. He's bisexual. So we'd been dating for just under a month at this point. Entitled Aunt was the only one that didn't know about this, for obvious reasons. Now, back to the story. We arrived about 1 o'clock to help set up the tables for the rest of the family. The only other people there were my grandparents, my uncle, mum's side, uncle's wife, my older cousin, EA and EC. Everything was okay for a while, but of course, this didn't last. My grandpa was always welcome to any friends or partners of the family, so he made sure that my boyfriend felt welcome. After about an hour, my grandpa, uncle and my boyfriend decided to head up to the attic to get some fishing gear for my boyfriend. My grandpa was a hoarder and tended to buy a lot of stuff from car boot sales that he would give away to family and friends. Does anyone else's grandparents do that, or is it just mine? That left myself, mum M, grandma GM, older cousin OC and EA. Uncle's wife went to the store and EC was playing in the park across the street. I was in the middle of braiding my older cousin's hair when my boyfriend left, so he gave me a peck on the cheek and headed upstairs. And of course, Entitled Aunt was staring. Entitled Aunt said, "What was that?" I said, "What was what? Did he just kiss you?" Me, internally screaming, yeah. "You're not going to do something about it." I said, "What do you mean, EA?" "I mean you should knock that fairy out. Be a man for once, OP. Do you really want some random homophobic slurs taking advantage of you like that?" I said, "But he's not taking advantage." She said, "Boys don't kiss other boys, OP. You know that. He's supposed to be your friend and friends don't kiss each other." BS, I have a bunch of friends, male and female, that I have no issue with being affectionate with. My grandma says, "Oh, BF isn't OP's friend, he's his boyfriend. Aren't they sweet?" I love my grandma to pieces. She thought EA only had a problem because she thought BF and I were just friends. EA said, "What? You're not serious, are you? OP's a homophobic slur." Mum said, "Yes, BF is OP's boyfriend. They're an adorable couple and everyone in the family has been accepting." She said, "Everyone knows apart from me. OP, why would you do this to me?" I said, "EA, I didn't want to exclude you, but I knew you were going to act like this when I told you." OC says, "You constantly berate him for not being man enough and using disgusting slurs when you talk about him. Can you blame OP for not wanting to tell you?" The aunt says, "I never meant it. That's just how I talk. If OP had told me, then I would have stopped." Mum says, "No, you wouldn't. He's asking you countless times. So have I. Why do you think I stopped talking to you for ages? I'm not having that kind of attitude around my son. He's not going to feel unwelcome in his own family." The aunt says, "But I'm not trying to make him uncomfortable. I can help him now I know what the problem is." My mum says, "What do you mean, help him? It's obvious, isn't it? He just hasn't met the right girl yet. He's only little." "I'm not 5, EA. I helped set him up with a nice girl. There's some lovely girls in our neighbourhood who would love a boyfriend like OP." She turned to me, held my hand. I'd finished my cousin's hair by now, and smiled at me. She said, "Doesn't that sound nice, OP? We'll get you a nice little girlfriend. A sweet boy like you wouldn't have any problems with girls, right?" Okay, first she winked at me, gross, and secondly, "I don't want a girlfriend, EA." I said, "I don't want a girlfriend, I'm happy the way I am." She said, "You can't be happy like that, doll. You're going to end up dead because of this. People get killed for being like that, you know." OC said, "They get murdered by bigots like you who don't think it's right." EA said, "It isn't right, I'm only looking out for OP. OC, if you weren't so obsessed with looking kind, then you'd tell him what he's doing is wrong. I don't want this kind of influence around EC. OC then says, "Then don't bring her to family events then." EA, ignoring OC and looking at my mum. "You know there's some places in the world that do conversion therapy. I can help you a little to pay for him to get that. They'll be able to fix him." "No. Just no, EA." At this point, my cousin looks like she's about to punch this bitch into next week, and my mum and grandma are focused on trying to help me calm down. I felt like I was on the verge of a panic attack. EA said, "You encouraged this," pointing at my mum. "You let him act like a homophobic slur all the time when he was little, playing with Barbies and wearing pink all the time. Actually, it was purple and red, EA. Get your facts straight, BH. Grandma said, that's enough. If I hear any more of this nonsense, then you and EC can get your stuff and leave. You're not making my grandson uncomfortable on my watch. She said, but, and Grandma cuts her off. I said, enough. If you want to act like a psycho about it, then how about you go to your own mum's house? GM knew this would piss EA off. EA's mum and dad stopped talking to her after they caught her stealing from them. The only reason my grandparents allowed her to visit was so that EC wouldn't feel abandoned. Plus, they kept an eye on her and made sure nothing went missing. EA looked like she both wanted to slap my grandma and burst into tears. Nothing else was said for the most part. My grandma pulled me aside and reminded me that she loved me and told me to ignore entitled aunt. She's just a bigot. I found out later that EA had been telling other family members about me being gay, hoping they'd side with her. They didn't. She eventually left after a couple of hours, but made sure to share things online about conversion therapy, how gay people can be cured, and even gave my number to a few of her friends' daughters and nieces, trying to set me up with them. I actually have one of the girls as a friend online. She thought that EA was being ridiculous. BF and I dated until we were around 17. We're still good friends and text/video call whenever we can. He's currently staying abroad. He and my current boyfriend are really good friends as well. So that's my story of how my psychotic entitled aunt found out I was gay. I'm surprised she was shocked by it. I think everyone in my family saw it coming. Anyways, I hope to be able to post another installment soon. Stay safe, my lovelies. I hope you're having a great day, despite the lockdown and stuff.
Oh my god.
At a family reunion, you're trying to pull that shit. I'm surprised you didn't get kicked out earlier, man. Our next story is from It's Just a Me. Entitled Mum Bullies Me While Shopping. This one just blew my mind and seriously ticked me off. This happened yesterday. I tried to type any dialogue to the best of my recollection. I ended up at the grocery store because I realised there was a few necessities I forgot to stock in preparation for my family's self-isolation. Shopping was relatively easy, though it was fairly busy. People wore masks and kept a wide berth from one another. When I got to the checkout section, I was satisfied because everyone kept about 6 feet between themselves and others in line. I stepped into a line that had one woman in it. Her purchases were already on the conveyor belt, and she was standing down by the cashier about 6 feet in front of me. She had an empty cart behind her, so my shopping cart was pushed up against hers. Brilliant way to force distancing, by the way. Now, in American groceries, it's common that the aisle dividers at the end of the conveyor belt extend 3 to 5 feet, so the shops can stock the shelves with impulse items. Since I was at the end of the conveyor belt and the aisle dividers extended, I was essentially trapped. Enter EM, her husband, and their 3-year-old daughter. Ian and her husband step up right behind me. I could practically feel the husband's breath when he spoke. Ian is holding a 3-year-old in her arms. I could reach out and touch them all without fully extending my arms. I said, whoa, can you please back up? The experts are recommending a distance of 6 feet during this pandemic. Ian was seriously straight up bitch attitude. Excuse you, I'm fine where I am. Why, you think you're some sort of Disney princess that can get people to do what you want if you snap your fingers? I'm flabbergasted. Please back up. You're entirely too close to me. EM said, I ain't sick, princess. Mind your expletive business. I said, can you please back up so I can exit this line? You can have my spot. EM and her husband back up and allow me to pull my cart out of line. As I'm walking towards the next cashier, I hear EM. Told you this works. Now, I got the impression that EM intended to run me out of the line because of this statement. It was something conspiratorial in the delivery. I could be wrong, of course. Well, when I stepped into another cashier's line, the cashier I left began having some sort of system errors. All of the lines were 3 or 4 people deep, so lucky me. EM and her family repeat the same behaviour behind me. The entire family is once again within hugging distance, or perhaps punching distance. EM smiles smugly. I'm ticked, and it bled into my verbiage. I said, you should be ashamed of yourself. You're risking your daughter's health, my health, to prove some sort of point that is entirely lost on me. Do you need to establish dominance? Back up and let me leave this line. EM said, shut the expletive up. My daughter isn't sick. I take care of my kid. I said, your daughter isn't sick yet. You keep playing these stupid games and you'll win stupid prizes and your daughter may get a participation trophy. I'm moving past her and towards another line. I decided to get into a line behind 2 individuals practicing distancing. EM steps up to the register and loudly begins to complain to the cashier. She said, you need to kick that woman out of your store. She just told me she hopes my daughter gets corona. The cashier said, lady, I don't have the patience for you today. I saw what happened. You were out of line. End of discussion. The woman in line ahead of me starts laughing. I'm smiling like a vindicated idiot. She said, are you kidding me? You're out of line. I want to talk to your manager. The cashier said, sure, no problem. When you leave, just call the store and we'll get him on the phone for you. Ian said, no, I want to talk to him now. And the cashier said, and I want a Hemsworth brother waiting naked in my bed when I get home. Neither of these things are going to happen. At this point, I've decided I wish I were a man, because I am in sort of love with this cashier. He's definitely won me over. EM said, how dare you be so vulgar in front of my daughter? The cashier said, the same daughter that heard you tell another customer to shut the duck up. The EM was ticked, but shut her mouth for the remainder of the interaction. I eyed her the whole time, waiting for her to lose her marbles. The husband never spoke to anyone other than EM. She ended up exiting the store before me. Of course, as she exited, she kept promising to call the manager and have the witty cashier's job. After she left, the cashier turned around and gave me the proudest, cheesiest smile and said, I got your back, sis. I love him. Edited. Other words were exchanged between the cashier and EM. However, I only shared what parts of the conversation I felt I remembered correctly, which was the beginning of their interaction. The EM didn't raise her voice anymore, so the rest of it was a bit anticlimactic. Fair play to the cashier though, you gotta give him that. If he's gonna be witty, I mean, I imagine cashiers at the moment are at their wit's end with everything that's going on. As I said in my last one, I know a cashier who had someone cough in her face because she wasn't allowed to give them, I think it was like 3 or 4 pints of milk when they're only allowed 2 at the time because of everyone panic buying and stuff. So yeah, I can imagine they're pretty pissed off at this moment in time. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed today's stories. And if you did, please let me know which of these stories were your favorites in the comments below. Thank you for your time out of your day. Much love to you. And I will see you in the next one. Take care now.